Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all my dear students. I hope you all are doing well at your home. Now students, be ready to learn English. Now today we'll learn story writing. In previous classes, students, you have learned how to write paragraph, how to write story through pictures. Yes, you have seen pictures and you have written story. But today we'll learn story, how to write meaningful story by using outlines. So students, first of all, open your GrammarGet textbook and open at page number 135. There is written the how to write the meaningful story by using outlines. Now here I have given you many important points. So first of all, look here. When you write a story, we must remember some important rules. A good story should have the following characteristics. Now students, pay attention here in your phone, because in your textbook only the outline is given. I just want to show you that which things are known as outlines. What is outlines? There are only outlines given in your textbook. Now look these characteristics in your video. That first one, firstly ensure that you have clear idea of the plot of the story. That whatever outlines given, you know, first of all you have to read the outlines which is given. After, you must be very clear about the ideas, about the story's ideas. Second one, the order of the points given in the outline should be followed. Yes, there is many outlines, many words are given as the outlines. So you must have to follow each and every outline in a proper way. If you will skip one of the outlines, so what happened? Your story must be not following the perfect idea because you skipped any one idea between. So might be your story not become a meaningful story. Connect the points given in the outline naturally using your imagination. Now sometimes what happened that we might be not aware of that particular incident. So that time you have to use your own idea or you have to use your own imagination. So here that you must be clear about the idea of the plot of the story. And after, the second point is very important that you don't have to skip any points which is given in an outline. Otherwise, might be your story will not become the meaningful. And the next thing is that you have to use your own imagination to complete this story. Might be you will not aware or you haven't any experience related to this, but you have to use your own imagination to write the meaningful story. Now look at the number 4, that is make it interesting by introducing dialogue or conversation. Though it's a story of an animal, though it's a story of trees or any non-living things, you have to make the dialogues between it. That time you don't have to think that these animals, how to speak. How we can say that the animal is speaking with each other. You don't have to think about it, you have to use your imagination the how two animals are talking with each other, and you have to make your story interesting. So dialogues and conversations are very important in this story. The character should seem real. Though it's a non-living character, then also you have to present the character in such a way so they will look like a real character. The conclusion of the story should be interesting. A surprise ending makes the story interesting. Yes, conclusion means at the end of the story. And you know students, the end of any story must be very interesting. If you are watching any film or any serials or anything, you know the ending must be very attractive. The ending must be very interesting. So same in a story also, while writing story, you are writing all the details about the story, about the characters, and after the ending, if you are not writing anything in the ending, which is not catching the reader. So your story might be not proper. So you have to write the conclusion, you have to write the ending of your story interesting, which can catch the reader to read more. If you are asked to supply heading or title, you may choose the main character, object or incident of the story. Yes, here might be sometimes what happened that you confused that which kind of title you have to give. So that time, sometimes the main characters also you can give. Suppose that you are writing a story of a thirsty crow. So that time you know that here the main incident is that one crow who is thirsty and who has done a lots of hard work to drink water. So that time you have to write only that thirsty crow. Suppose there is a story of a tiger and lion. That time you did not recognize that which is the main idea inside this story. So you can just write the title. You can just write the character of that character as a title of this story. Or suppose you understood the whole story very well and you have written very nice. So might be there is a one main incident. So you can give that incident also. Suppose that there is a story of a stag. Foolish stag who is watching his legs in a water reflection and who is feeling that he has a very ugly legs and who has a very beautiful horns, and after the legs only help him to rid up from these hunters. So that time you can write the title as a foolish stag. So here you know the incident proper, you understood the story very well. So that time you can write the incident also, main incident, as a title. To make the story readable and interesting, use idiomatic expressions, adjectives and phrase to describe people, actions, thoughts or words. Sometimes we have to use the idioms also, phrases also, adjectives also. And students, I hope that you know very well what is this all things. Very easy to use adjectives, that in place of a simple words you can make nice, beautiful, very bad, very nice, so sweet, etc. Like these words, which is known as adjectives, which adding something into the noun. I told you before also that suppose that there is a story of a tiger, you can write that a very powerful tiger, or you can say that very very brave tiger who knows the king of the jungle and etc. So you can use any your own thoughts, phrase, idioms, etc. to make your story very interesting. So students, while writing story, these all points you have to remember. And you have to follow these all points, so definitely your story become very interesting. And the reader who is reading your story will be definitely get interest to read your whole story. Now here I have one example of a story. Now look here students, this is known as outlines. Means not the complete points I have written. I have written the main points. Now you have to write in a detailed way this all points without skip any outline. Write a readable story by using the heads given below. Give it a suitable title. Now here it's already written that you have to write a suitable title. And always remember that students, at the end of the story, you don't forget to write moral of the story. That which message you got from this story. Now first of all, every time, remember students that you have to read all outlines. You are reading first outline, then you started writing story, then reading next. It's not a proper way to write story. So better what we have to do while writing story from the outlines. First we have to read all the outlines. So let's see everybody. Son falls into bad company, disobeys his parents, loses interest in studies. Father decides to bring the son back to the right path. Gives him a few apples. places a rotten apple among the good ones. After a few days, the good apples also become rotten. Sun understands the one rotten apple spoils all the apples, tries to mend his ways, gets transformed and moral. So here from the outline you understood that this is a story of one father and his son. Now his father was worried about his son, that his son who went to outlines means who has a bad company of friends. Now his father worried, his father want to take his son back from this bad company. So one idea is done by his father, that things you have to write in a detail. So first of all you have to understand this outline, then you have to start writing the story. Now look at this story, I have already written for it. Now first of all I have given the title, A Rotten Apple Spoils the Whole Barrel. Once there was a man whose son fell into bad company. Under the influence of his friends, he got into some bad habits. Now in place of once there was a man, you can write the name of the man also. That once there was this man who has this name son. You can write the name of son too. Under the influence of his friends, he got into some bad habits. He started disobeying his parents. He would waste his time watching television with the result that his grades in school came down, and he even flunked in one or two subjects. His father grew worried and decides to teach his son a lesson. So here in these, without skip of any outline, you have to take all the outlines one by one and you have to make a story. But in the beginning, you can write anything. That once there was Muhammad, a father whose son Rayyan fell into bad company. You can write the name of man also, you can write the name of son. Even if he wants to write that once there was a village, so you can write the village name also. It will make your story very interesting. Now you have already written that what happened. Under the influence of his friends, he got into some bad habits. Influence of his friends means that he learned these bad things from his friend. And what he started to do? He started to disobeying his parents. He's not listening to his parents. And what he's doing, he's wasting his time to watching television, cartoons, videos, etc. And what's the result happened? That his grades in school means earlier might be he got A plus, now he's getting B plus, C, etc. Even what happened after earlier, it's affected grades, but now he is getting failing marks in some subject also. So his father was worried about his future and his father has teach him a lesson. He gave a few apples to his son. He then quietly placed a rotten apple among the good ones. And which trick his father has done? His father has given him some rotten. Rotten means which is not good one, which is like a waste apple, which we have to throw in a dustbin. But instead of to throw dustbin, his father has given one basket of apple, in which his father gave him one rotten apple also to keep inside with the good ones. After a few days, when the son was about to take out an apple from the basket, he found that all the apples were rotten. Now what happened? After 1 week or after 2-3 days, when he went to take apple, that time he got that all apples are become waste, all apples are become rotten. He asked his father the reason for this. His father pointed out that he had deliberately placed one rotten apple in the basket. When he asked his father that why these things happen, So if father has given answer that deliberately means intentionally, very willingly, he kept one bad apple inside this good ones. And what happened? All the apple it's become rotten. His son was surprised to see that one rotten apple had spoiled the entire lot. He was surprised that only one apple had made another 10 apples which were good before, it's also become rotten like this one. He now understood the reason for his downfall. He thanked his father for making him realize his mistake in his choice of friends. He immediately left their company and was transformed into a new individual. So here, this boy understood his mistake and why he is also failing in exams. He understood now. Now he left these bad company friends and he started to become a good one. He made his own company of good and he's become a very good boy who always listening his parents. So students, here I just written one example. You can write this whole story your own also. You can make your own story. But here no need to write in SCW, it's only for your knowledge. I will send you PDF also. Then only you will write in your CW. Now look at students, here I have written more of the story. A person is known by the company he keeps. Yes, suppose that you are always sitting with those people who are very good, who are always obeying their parents. So you know, everybody will look you also like this, that you are also very good. You also obeying your parents, etc. But if you are wandering and moving with this type of people who's not listening, who's not obeying their parents, so though you are very good, everybody will know like this only that you are also bad like this company. So we have to always move and wander with the good person, with the good people's company. So this is only the moral. You can write another moral also. According to your understanding of the story, you can write different moral also of this story. So students, this way we have to write, we have to use the outlines to make a readable or meaningful story. So I hope students that you are clear about this story writing. If you have any doubts related to this, so you can write in the comment box. So in the next video, first of all, I explain you how to write story. Then I give you one task also to write the story. Thank you all and have a beautiful day ahead.